It's Gwen here. Today I'm going to teach you how to make a awesome flavored, totally. No, I'm going to show you how to make flavored lip gloss or chapstick. So let's go to the kitchen and see what we need.
First thing you're going to need is a couple of extracts, ones that you like. And since this is for holiday gifts, I chose some holiday ones like red velvet because I always think of baking. And I think of the holidays, and peppermint like candy canes.
Okay, so the next thing that you're gonna need is some petroleum jelly, and you can get that for a pretty good price at either CVS or somewhere like that, or even the grocery store.
The next thing you're going to need are a couple glass or microwavable bowls. So since I'm doing four different extracts or flavors, there's my cat, that I'm going to use four different bowls.
But if you want to dye your lip gloss or chapstick, then use some food coloring dye. This one I'm going to use.
You need some paper plates and paper towels because it is pretty messy.
But definitely not least, because this is like the most important one, something to put it in. I suggest using paint pots because they're really cheap and it comes with quite a few. I mean, this was like $2 and it came with 18 paint pots. And you can get them from Michael's. That's where I got them because Michael's is awesome. Don't go to Hobby Lobby.
Okay, so first thing, oh yeah, also want a spoon. Spoons are important. You really need that. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to put down one of our magnificent paper towels, like so. Gosh, what about the picture? Okay, paper towel down. Yeah, okay. So now we are going to get one of our glass bowls and we're going to put some petroleum jelly. I'm going to put a spoonful, very big, heaping, huge spoonful in there. We want to get it down in the bowl if the bowl wants to. Actually, I'm going to do two because making quite a bit here. So, yeah, now your hands are going to be messy. That's why lots of paper towels and stuff. Okay, so now you're going to pick one of your flavors. I'm going to do peppermint first. And so you're going to put some in. I don't know. You basically choose how much. Just don't put more than like a spoonful. Don't put, like, a spoonful. Maybe, like, half or a quarter of a spoonful. So that way it's, like, flavorful enough. Because it's kind of hard to make it flavorful enough. Normally you wouldn't use as much, by the way, for other stuff. But you have to kind of use a lot for this. And then, since I want to color this one, I'm going to put in, because I want to make it green, because that makes me think of peppermint. Ugh, I'm just dumping these out. Okay, so, green, yeah. You don't have to do it this way, but I want to. So, just gonna put like 2 to 3 drops in. And then you're going to mix it all around in your bowl, like so. Mix it into that petroleum jelly. Till it is all evenly mixed in, like so. Okay, and got paper plates here for a really good reason, to cover it, because if you do not cover it, as I learned the first time I did it, kind of explodes all over your microwave. Took me a while to clean it. Yeah, it wasn't very fun either. So now we are going to put it in the microwave.
So now we're going to put it in the microwave with this on top so it doesn't explode everywhere. So we are going to put it in
for 80 to 90 seconds, depending on how much you put. I'm going to put 80 to this one, and that's it.
Okay, so let's get our paint pots. If they don't stick together. Okay, so put it on the paper towel. Just get that ready for when it comes out the microwave.
Forget kids, you must thumbs up this video or there will be a zombie apocalypse.
You know, because of course she's a subscriber.
Okay, so I just pulled it out of the microwave, and it is a complete liquid. You are going to keep microwaving until it's a complete liquid. Very important, in case you couldn't tell by my repetitive speaking in this. Okay, so it's going to be pretty hot, so you're going to want to grab this. So, you can move it, and then just so it doesn't get everywhere, gonna put our paint pots on here. Now we're going to take the spoon out, put that on the paper towel, and we are going to pour it into the paint pots, not the paint blitz, whatever. I don't even know what I was saying. Okay, so gonna pour it in. Pour it in. Whoa, I put way too much in that one. It's okay if you spill it. That's why we have the plate underneath. Really, there's not really much you can do with the leftover, so I don't know. I'm gonna fill some more. So now, the reason we have the paper towel is we can put the filled paint pots on the paper towel to dry, because see how much that collected? So now we're just going to pour it into some more paint pots, because we don't want to waste anything, you know? That's not cool. Messy stuff. Okay, so now we're just going to pour some more. Doop 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 doop. This is really hot. Doop 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 doop. I'm burning my fingers. Doop 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 doop. Wow, so I guess two heaping spoonfuls can fill up almost two complete paint pots. There's only one empty there. So that is awesome. Right, right. That's where you guys are like, that's awesome. I don't think I can get enough left over. Let's see. I think I can get enough left over to put into here. And they're going to start drying pretty quick. So, you want to go fast with this process, as I just totally failed on that one. Okay, so now let's move that all the way. Let's put these out of the way. Woohoo! Okay, now we're going to do next batch. We're going to do exactly the same. Just put petroleum jelly. Okay, so you're going to do everything exactly the same, so I'm going to do it fast motion so you still see. So, yeah. Tell me, is this the part when we are lit one. Just came out of the microwave. So remember, guys, do it on the plate. Where's the plate? Here's the plate. Plate. That's good. Okay, so... Whoa, this one's awkward. It only has 5. Make sure the lids are kind of like leaning on this edge so then it's not tilted some funky way. So now we're just gonna pour it in. And try not to spill a lot because most of what gets spilled is wasted because it dries there. And then that sucks. So try not to waste any. Won't spill any, which is also wasting it. So yeah. Now we're pouring some more. Just like fill it to the top. Make sure not to fill it too much or then it's hard to close and stuff. And then that's bad. So, voila, we're gonna set those to the side and let them dry. It's time for our next batch. There is nothing left out of everything we were. Watching and don't forget to subscribe because I will have lots more videos and comment below what you think I should do for my next video or any questions, and I always love to see pictures of what you guys do, so just send them to me via Instagram or whatever, or put like hashtag, I don't know, put ideas for my hashtag in the comments below. And so here's your finished project. Well, see, I put it in a little gift box, so I'm going to give it to my friends. See, you have your little chapstick. And you can open it up. Well, I can't right now. But. So you can either put it like in a little gift box like this, which you can get from Michael's for real cheap. Or you can tie it up in some clearish fabric or tulle, which you can also get for a really good price at Michael's or Dan's. Somewhere that sells fabric, and then you can just use little hair ties like these, which I got from Charming Charlie's for like $3. I got a whole pack on Black Friday, so super cute, super easy. Love it. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget, I'm missing you.